the newly graduated pharmacists have the best opportunity to start their career as regulatory professionals in Regulatory Affairs Department of Pharmaceutical Industry. Pharmaceutical Regulatory Affairs is a new profession which developed from the desire of governments to protect public health by controlling the safety and efficacy of products in areas including pharmaceuticals, veterinary medicines, medical devices, pesticides, agrochemicals, cosmetics, and complementary medicines. Regulatory professionals help the company avoid problems caused by badly kept records, inappropriate scientific thinking, or poor presentation of data. The function of regulatory professionals in pharma industry is to provide all the legal information like updates in amendments in law, new drug inventions, drug development designs, patent, trademark and copyrights, information about pharmaceuticals and biological drugs, guidance regarding rules and regulations of drugs, latest good manufacturing practices, science and technologies update and their regulatory aspect, post-marketing surveillance of the products and to compile the documentation of the pharma industry according to the requirements of regulatory authority or governing body of that country or the country where products are proposed to be exported. Now the question must be, why a pharmacist should join Regulatory Affairs Department of Pharma Industry? It is a speedily growing department of pharma industry because most of the stakeholders are now interested in export of their pharmaceutical products in other countries. But international markets demand strict regulations and legal requirements in terms of allowing marketing authorization of pharmaceutical products. Internationally, many countries require pharmaceutical dossier or common technical document format for registration of the products or marketing authorization of the products. CTD is the set of the documents ensuring quality, safety and efficacy of the pharmaceutical or biological products which should be prepared according to the requirement of regulations prescribed by the governing authority of the country. This CTD is to be evaluated by the regulatory authority of that country before giving marketing authorization to the products. Most of the countries require CTD format prescribed by ICH guidelines for registration of pharmaceutical products. ICH stands for International Council of Harmonization. The economically developing countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh, India and Nepal are also implementing this format for registration of medicinal products in their own countries as per ICH guidelines. Actually, ICH guidelines is a set of parameters designed by the United States of America, Japan and European Commission countries to promote harmonization in the regulatory guidelines of each and every country being member of the United Nations for the purpose to deliver quality, safe and efficacious medicines to each and every person on this earth.
You can easily find the regulatory guidelines on the official website of ICH guidelines. Spend your time to get grip on the four topics in these guidelines, that is quality, safety, efficacy and multidisciplinary guidelines. When you will click on the Q, S, E and M on the site of ICH guidelines, you will get further guidelines regarding pharmaceuticals and biological products. Also visit the official website of Regulatory Affairs Professional Society, that is REPS, and the Organization for Professionals in Regulatory Affairs, that is TOPRA, and get the membership for regular updates in the regulatory affairs and also become part of the global regulatory professional community. Keep visiting official websites of United States Federal Drug Administration, that is US FDA, and European Medicine Agency, EMA, Parenteral Drug Administration, that is PDA, to remain up to date with latest news in the regulatory affairs of pharmaceutical and biological products. Now, United Nations Environmental Protection Program, also heading towards control of hazardous waste generated from pharmaceutical industry in the low-income countries or developing countries, where regulations are weak in control of waste of hazardous substances and environment is getting polluted, from pharmaceutical waste due to consumption of hazardous chemicals in testing of drugs and direct discharge of pharmaceutical waste in the sewage or drain. Safety officer in the regulatory professionals of a pharma industry is now responsible to generate procedures to not drain the hazardous waste in the sewage line, but to make guidelines for collection of these hazardous waste in the container prescribed by the Environment Protection Agency and to proper disposal by the agency. Safety officer in the pharma industry is also responsible for safety of the personnels dealing with the hazardous chemicals. He should remain updated with rules and regulations and procedures developed by Environmental Protection Agency for waste disposal and chemical handling in the industry. So, this is the right time for newly graduated pharmacist to step in regulatory affairs officer pharmaceutical industry to start career and to get experience and knowledge and to serve the nation with a life-saving attitude. Thanks for watching our video. If you like this video, then share it on your social networks to enhance the community of caring people and subscribe to our channel to have more videos on these topics.